Welcome to the third video of Selenium Webdrivers series from H2K Infosys. H2K Infosys is based out of Georgia, Atlanta, USA, and it gives world-class IT training which can be on-site, off-site, online. In this particular series, the third video, I'm going to stick towards the environment, which is Selenium 3, Beta 3 version. And if I find any difficulty in this particular version, I will revert back to Selenium 2.5.3.1. So this video will contain the particular topics like the Firefox binary class, creating the Chrome log, understanding the difference between close and quit method of the WebDriver API, and importing the WebDriver documentation in Eclipse. So let's start with Firefox binary class. Firefox binary class is an inbuilt class of Selenium WebDriver which can be used to pinpoint the Firefox exe, that is the Firefox executable. Now by default, Firefox binary should be used when the Firefox driver class object is not able to open up the Firefox browser. That is where we need to use the Firefox binary class. And this kind of situation is very rare, that it is not able to open the Firefox browser by using the Firefox driver class. So under that circumstances, we need to use the Firefox binary class as a whole. Now, since this is a new version of Selenium, that is 3 series, the Firefox binary class works a bit differently as compared to the earlier series of Selenium, that is the 2 series. And the last version of Selenium WebDriver 2 series was 2.53.1. So we are going to see the usage of Firefox binary in Selenium WebDriver version 2.53.1, and also see the usage of Firefox binary class in Selenium WebDriver version 3, beta 3 version. As far as the version 2.53.1 is concerned, what we need to do is that we need to first create an object of the Firefox binary class and pass the constructor of the file class object as an argument of the Firefox binary object. The file class object pass should use an argument which pinpoints the Firefox exe. And generally the Firefox exe is present in the driver of your computer where your OS is installed. Now the reference variables of the Firefox binary object and the Firefox profile object needs to be passed as a constructor of the Firefox driver class. So if you want to understand it, we have to understand it practically, how to use the Firefox binary class in version 2.53.1. And that is what I'm going to show you right now. So I'll open up my Eclipse out here. And I'm going to create a new project. And the project will be called as Selenium 3. And in this project, I need to actually use the WebDriver version 2.53.1 jar files. So where do I download it from? So I need to open up Chrome. And in Chrome, I need to go to www.seleniumhq.org. And if I go to the download section, I'll see there is a previous release link present in the left-hand pane. So I click out here and I want to basically use 2.53.1 version. So I'll go to 2.53 link, click out there, and here I will see the Selenium Java 2.53.1 zip file. So I need to download this by clicking on this particular link. So this zip file will contain the jar files of Selenium 2.53.1 version. Once it downloaded, I will open the folder. And this is where it is, so I'll cut it out from here, and generally I'll keep it in my repo, and my repo will be okay. Let's do one particular thing, that this is where it got downloaded, so I will extract it out here. So you can extract it wherever you wish to. And it creates a should create a folder with the same name. This is the folder, and these are the jar files inside 2.53.1. these are the two jar files, and other jar files are present in the libs folder of the 2.53.1 folder. So here it is. So what I need to do is go back to my Selenium 3 project, and in the libraries tab, add the external jar files. So I need to pinpoint to the download section. This is the folder. This folder has these two jar files. Click on open. This will add up the two jar files, and then add the other jar files which are present in the libs folder. Control A, click on open. Go to order and export, select all, and say finish. Say no to the perspective. So this is how I have now attached the jar files of Selenium 2.53.1 with Selenium 3 project. So in this, I will create a package called as using Firefox binary. Click on finish. And inside this package, I'm going to create a new class file called as, let's say, Google search application. So click on the main method and say finish. Now please understand that in the 2 series of Selenium, we do not have to use the system.setProperties method in order to set up the system property for the Firefox browser. Okay, the Firefox browser will open directly by using the Firefox driver class. But in Selenium 3 series, that is beta 3 version, if you want to use the Firefox browser, we have to set up the system property. And we have seen that in the earlier video. So in this particular version 2.53, we do not have to set up any system property for opening up the Firefox browser. We can directly use the Firefox driver class object and open up the Firefox browser for it. So this is the object of the Firefox driver class. We need to import this particular class file. So just hover our mouse over the red underline. We can import it. Okay. Here we don't need to set up the property. Sometimes what happens is that when we create an object to the Firefox driver class, it is not able to open up the Firefox browser as far as version 2.53.1 of Selenium is concerned. Rather, the version 2 series of Selenium WebDriver will work in this particular manner, that sometimes when we use the Firefox driver class object, it doesn't open up the Firefox browser. That's where we need to use the Firefox binary to pinpoint to the Firefox executable. So under circumstances, hypothetically, let's understand it will not open the Firefox browser. So what we need to do is that under that circumstances, we will use the Firefox binary class to pinpoint the Firefox executable. If the Firefox driver class object does not open the Firefox browser, so what we are going to do is that we are going to first create the Firefox binary class object. I'll call the reference variable as FB is equal to new Firefox binary and we got to pinpoint or import the Firefox binary class which belongs to the Selenium package as a whole. Out here, as an argument of the Firefox binary object, we need to pass on the object of the file class. So what we can do is new file, and inside the argument of the file object we need to pass on the path where the firefox.exe is present. Import the file class from the IO package. Okay, and where is firefox.exe is present? Now, as I've told, that firefox.exe is already present in the driver of your computer where you have installed your OS. So generally what happens is that my OS is installed in the C driver. So this is my C driver. So generally the firefox.exe is present in program files x86 or program files. Choose one of them and check out a folder called as Mozilla. So I have my Mozilla Firefox folder in program file x86. If you do not have in program files x86, revert to program files only. There's one more folder called program files out here. So I have it out here. So I will go to this Mozilla Firefox folder, open it up, and this is where the executable of Firefox is present. It's called firefox.exe. So I'll pick up the path, copy, go to my script and put the path out here. Put a backward slash and I need to write down firefox.exe and ensure that we use a script sequence if you're using a backward slash. Done. Now let's go back to the Firefox driver class in our Java doc documentation and check out how do we use the Firefox binary class. Okay, it is very important to check out. So what we need to do is go back to our documentation, and the documentation is present in seleniumhq.org, the download section. Go to the Java documents and open up the Firefox driver class. And if you go to the constructor out here, the constructor says that you can use Firefox binary with Firefox profile. This is what is important. We cannot use Firefox binary, we cannot pass on the constructor of Firefox binary class inside the Firefox driver object. We need to use the Firefox profile also. There is no constructor which says that we can use simply the Firefox binary class as a constructor of Firefox driver class object. We have to use either this constructor, which I am highlighting, or this constructor. That means apart from Firefox binary, I also need to use the constructor of the Firefox binary profile object inside the Firefox drivers class object. And this is why we need to also then create an object of the Firefox profile class. So we'll go back to our script, and what we are going to do is that we are going to create a profile, use the Firefox profile class object. So we know that the profiles can be noted by using the profiles INI class. So create an object of the profiles INI class, which we have seen earlier in our earlier videos. I'll call the reference variable as P is equal to new profiles INI. Import this particular profiles INI. And use the reference variable of the profiles INI. This will give you the method. So we need to use the getProfile method of the profiles INI class. So which particular profile do you want to use? So last time I had created a profile called as H2K Infosys. If you are not sure, then what you need to do is, first of all, if you have an open Firefox browser, close it and then fire the command called firefox.exe space hyphen p space profile manager in the search button out here. Then you can see what is the profile and what is the uppercase and lowercase maintained in the profile that I created. So I remember that I've created this particular profile, and the return type of get profile method is Firefox profile. I'll reference the Firefox profile with FP and import the Firefox profile class. Now, since the documentation says that I need to use this particular constructor where I pass on the Firefox binary class and the Firefox profile after that, so we'll use this particular constructor out here. So we'll go back to our script, and in the constructor I'll first pass on the Firefox binary referenced by the reference variable FP and then FP. This will open up the Firefox browser right now. So under circumstances when the Firefox browser is not opening by using this class object which I'm highlighting, you need to use the Firefox binary class like this. And since the constructor of Firefox driver does not only have Firefox binary, you need to use the Firefox profile also to pass on the constructor of the Firefox driver class object. And this is happening because of this documentation given out here. You cannot simply use the Firefox binary class inside the constructor of the Firefox driver. You got to use either Firefox profile class file, or you can use Firefox binary, Firefox profile and capabilities interface too. So I'm sticking to this particular highlighted constructor, and that is why based on the constructor I'm creating the constructor out here. Okay, so right now after this, then I can actually open the Firefox browser, and after this I can navigate to Google. For that I need to use driver dot get method, and I will give http://www.google.com. So let's open up Google out here, and using the inspect element, let us inspect the HTML script containing the ID whose value is LSTIB. So I'll copy this, go back to my script and typing the keyword, and the keyword is your Selenium, for example. So I need to use driver dot find element by using the by classes method called as the ID method. This is one of the locating strategies of Selenium Webdriver. There are 8 locating strategies. Out of them, ID is one of the locating strategies. And in this, we paste the value of the ID that we have copied from the HTML script of that particular edit box present in the Google application. Dot the sendKit method to be used to type the characters, which is Selenium. So if I type Selenium out here, the Google search still remains in the same location, the Google search button. So I'll get the HTML script of Google search button, and I have value of the name attribute as btnk. I'll copy this. So I'll use, since the name attribute has the value of btnk, I will have to use the locating strategy called name, which is another locating strategy of the Selenium WebDriver interface. So clicking the Google search button. So driver dot find element by the name locating strategy, and the name that I have copied, or the value of the name attribute that I've copied from the HTML script, is this. And I need to use the submit method because of the fact that this Google search button is present below the form tag. If I go up, I'll see the form tag somewhere out here. So since the Google search button is part of the form tag, we have to use the submit method. We don't have to use the click method. So as we have seen in the last video. Let us look at the volume. Yeah, volume is fine. So right now I can run the class file after saving it, and it will run it perfectly well.